laboratory developed this model, and this is going to be the most important preclinical tool used to understand individual tumor biology and also identify drug targets and test different novel targets. So what happens is that from the patient, they can take small part of the tumors and they can develop in outside in the culture, 3D culture, exactly the same architecture of tumor as you see in the patient. And this can be frozen. And after that, if you first run that in a mouse model orthotopically, it starts with the development of pre-cancer lesions and going to the advanced cancer. So this is one of the latest models. I just wanted to tell you about it. How much time do we have today? Okay, great. So I will take 10 more minutes, and please let me know if any of these points what I'm trying to make is not clear, so I can stop and then explain to you. Inflammation is an important component in pancreatic cancer development and progression. Chronic pancreatitis, as I mentioned, enhances the risk of pancreatic cancer. There are several oncogenic pathways that are constitutively active, for example, NF-kappa B, signaling, desmoplastic estroma, neodystroma, highly active inflammatory cells, and inflammatory cytokines, COX-2 and NOS-2, these are the two enzymes that catalyze the different reactions that produces reactive species. So if you look at the schematics of normal pancreatic intraepithelial neoplastic lesions, precursor lesions, and see that you see a stepwise accumulation of inflammatory changes here that accumulates over different stages. There are also evidence which shows that, as I mentioned, KRAS mutation is very important. It activates KRAS, and more than 95% of the patients have KRAS mutation, but all the mutated KRAS is not tumorigenic. So what has been shown that mutated KRAS has to reach a pathological level of activation, and that is provided by these reactive species that are generated during chronic inflammation. Just a minute. So one cytokine that we are working in my lab. So I will give you a in summary, from this last experiment which I showed you, is that the higher risk expression is associated with poorer outcome. This enhances growth and capacity of tumor xenografts in mice. This driven signaling inhibits NRG2, which is an it's a tumor suppressive, potentially tumor suppressive gene by upregulating SPO1D. And NRG2 is a negative regulator of EMT. This efficiency increases survival and reduces metastasis. Therefore, this SPO1D NRG2 signaling is a potential benefit. So I'd like to end with this one, which I showed right in the beginning, that in order to achieve early detection and effective therapy, we need to understand that are made in understanding pancreatic tumor biology, and now we are at a point that we have several leads that can be taken into the preclinical and clinical study. So I will stop here and check the question if you have any. Thank you very much for your attention and questions.
So does this have any effect on your
system? Yes, it does. So what happens that MIF enhances the level of MDH3 and the level of TWNT cells in the tumor. So when you check the tumors, MIF expressing and control tumors, we found that when you remove MIF, you have less of those tumors.
Thank you very much. So our next speaker is Dr. Marina Zamboni. She's a senior principal investigator at the Center for Immunology and Nanotechnology Center for Research and Biomedical and Project Maryland. She leads a team of scientists and technicians conducting preclinical studies to monitor adverse effects of nanoparticles to the immune system, both in vitro and in vivo. Her team strives to improve the understanding of mechanisms of nanoparticle immunotoxicity. She is a part of several nanomedicine working groups and has published more than 45 peer-reviewed journal articles on this topic. Her talk is entitled Nanotechnology for Cancer Therapy, Benefits, Concerns, and Effects of the Immune System. And good evening, everyone. So what I'm going to talk today about is the application of nanotechnology for cancer therapy. I would like to give a very general overview of the field to give you an idea of what nanotechnology can do for cancer therapy. We'll talk about the unique surface technology and some of the tools that we use in the cancer field.
This is me.池袋ってあります。はい。あ、はい。
これ誰？
まあいいわ。
Shown
Since the
14時35分の日比谷までっていくらですか？東京まで、
はい、1枚1000円です。2時50分のですぐ行きますか？
はい、
はい、ちょうど1000円いただきます。2時50分東京駅八重洲北口31番になります。外で右端です。
すいません。
2台出してますから、はい、2台目でお客様です、はい、1台目がここで満席になります。
はい、
from this access point, our program has performed once again.